For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. The hope of all that lived, all the hope of your soul, is rested upon the one that said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh unto the Father but by me. We're here to tell you and preach to you about the living hope, the blessed hope, the Lord Jesus Christ. Because we're here to tell you that one known fact that you know is true, you're going to die, and you're going to face eternity. And the Bible says that in eternity there is an afterlife, there's a heaven, or there's a hell, and there's nothing else. I don't care what your religion teaches. I don't care what you think. I don't care what you don't believe. God in his holy Bible has told you and has sent to you the message that there is eternal life. In order to attain eternal life, it is set out upon the gospel that Christ died for your sins, was buried according to the scriptures, and arose again the third day, all according to the scriptures. The Bible says, prepare to meet thy God. The Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, there is none righteous, no, not one. We come here loving you to prepare you for your death. We are here to tell you about the way, the truth, and the life set about upon the Lord Jesus Christ of myself, which April 24th, 1987, I received Christ as my Savior and settled my new destination to New Jerusalem. I now know, for the Bible says, these things have I written unto you that you may know you have eternal life. And that eternal life doesn't rest upon religion, because before I was saved, I had the number one religion in the world. And that gave me no hope. All that religion gave me was get out of it. Get out of it. And then I lived in a worldly religion. I lived in drugs. I lived in alcohol. I lived in womanizing. I lived in gambling. I lived in being a rebellion, which gave me no hope. Until one day, the King James Bible was opened up to me, and the way, the truth, and the life was shown to me. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. The Bible says that God is love. That is true. Yet, but we have a holy God. We have a holy God that cannot allow sin in his presence. And if you are still under your sin, you will never be under God. The only place that you can go with your sin still on your account is a place called hell. And yet the Bible says God is long-suffering. He is not willing that any should perish. God does not want you to go to the place that was made for Satan and his angels. And yet God so loved the world that God looked upon you, saw you in your worthless state. He gave. God has provided you with what you need. Just as much if you were to go to a doctor today and say, doctor, what is wrong with me? And that doctor does his test. And that doctor sits you down at his desk. And he says, patient, this is your ailment. Now here is your prescription. Go to the pharmacy and receive this prescription and follow my directions to be healed. Yet God, your heavenly doctor, your heavenly physician, has come down and shown you what's wrong with you. The wages of sin is death. You're going to die because you are a sinner.
Thanks for being here.
You cannot escape death because you are a sinner. That is your disease. That is your damnable disease, your condemnation disease, your disease that will bring to you death. It's just as worse as a cancer. For we are all sinners, for all have sinned. And yet, church can't do it. Only the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ can save you. Millions of people go into church and they think that they're going to heaven. Jesus Christ will say to you, quoted by Jesus himself, "Depart from me, I never knew you." But Lord, I went to the biggest church. Lord, I went to the first church. Lord, I went to this religion. Depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. You can't trust in religion. Religion is God. Religion is God's not appointed way. Religion is man's way. Religion is the result of Satan to turn you away from God. Religion is man-made. Jesus Christ is God-approved, God-sealed, God himself. For Jesus said, "I and the Father are one," John chapter 10, verse 30. That loving God that created you, the creator, not evolution. That loving God that made you, that saw you in your condition. The great doctor told you what your disease is. Your disease is terminal. And everybody has it. And there is one name for your condition. It's called sin. And until you settle your sin condition, you will die and you will face the eternal damnation by the holy God that loved you, that does not want you to go there. Again, that place is hell. People are in hell today because they have rejected what God has done for them. They have rejected what God has said to them. They have rejected the prescription that God has provided, and that prescription is Jesus Christ. You don't go to the pharmacist, you don't go to the pharmacy, you go to Calvary and meet the Son of God that died for your sins. And you ask God to forgive you of your sins, you repent of your sins, and you put your full, whole trust, nothing, upon the blood and the finished work of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. The Bible says, what must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Salvation is that simple. Salvation is not membership. Salvation is not baptism. Salvation is not you're a good person. For the Bible says there are none good, no, not one. If you stand to me and say, "Well, I'm a good person," the Bible says you are not, and that can't get you into heaven. Because somewhere in that body, somewhere in that heart, lies sin. And you've got a sin condition. Your condition today is sin. What is sin? To him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, James says to him, it is sin. I am telling you today what is good to do. What is good to do is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You have heard the gospel. You have heard the Bible. I have told you what God expects you to do. I am telling you what the Bible says what to do. What God has said to do. And you are without excuse if you choose to ignore the Word of God. I am here to tell you today that when you stand before God, I am giving you the Bible to explain to you, you are without excuse. Because you have heard the words of life. You have tasted of the bread. You have partaken of the honey. You have taken of the water of life, which is Jesus. You can never say to God, "I never knew," because I have spoken to you out of the Word. To believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Upon your ears, you can't tell God any excuse. No religion can do what God has done. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed him should not perish. one day you're going to close your earthly eyes. Those eyelids are looking at watermelons and tomatoes and lettuce and other people and babies and trees and rain and whatever you're looking at right now, those eyes will close upon a thing called death. And they will open into eternalness. Either you will see Jesus Christ, or you will see eternal damnation in which you cannot escape either. You'll never be on the streets of New Jerusalem and say, I want out of here. Man, this place is terrible. I want to get out of here. And yet, when you step into the realms of hell, you will wish you could be out of there and cannot. Listen, we are talking about something that's not going to end tomorrow and next month. We're talking about something that's going to be eternal forever, beyond all time. And your decision right now, where you will go when you die, is right now. What you choose right now will settle your destination, where you will be, where there will be no time. You have to face the fact is that life is just not what you see and feel and everything right now. This is not just life. This is just a moment of a time. This is a time that's a little dot on your tombstone. When you were born, when you die, this life right now is a little dash. And you got to realize that little dash is on your tombstone. What you do with that little dash will have your effect after you die. If you choose to believe Jesus Christ, that life will be eternal life with God who made you, with happiness, with no pain, no sorrow, the tears being wiped away, forever with the one that loved you. And yet if you choose to reject God and His offering, your damnation, your soul will be put into a burning fire, lake of fire for all eternity, where you will want God's mercy, you will want God's grace, and you will never get it because you have rejected God's offering today, His Son, the precious blood of the Lamb without spot, Jesus Christ, which is made to you today. And I tell you how much it costs. Free. Absolutely free. I don't want your money. God doesn't want your money. He wants your soul. He wants your faith. He wants you to believe without cash or money order, shipping and handling. And you can even get this tape, this video, you can get it online absolutely free. Go to my YouTube, go to my Facebook, and you can get this video. You can get this absolutely free to hear the gospel all over again, how Jesus loves you, how God loved you, that He sent His Son, that He may take your place. Because without the blood of Jesus Christ, you are still a sinner. And remember what sin does to you. Sin causes your death. It is said in John chapter 3, He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life. And he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. Let me tell you what the wrath of God is that you do not want to hear. The wrath of God is the lake of fire which you do not have to go to. This is the day of salvation. You can choose Christ as your Savior today. You can be washed in the blood. You can be made a child of God. You can have the Holy Spirit indwelling in your heart today that will change your ticket from hell to heaven by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ at the gate called Calvary. If you've never been to Calvary, you are not saved. If you do not have the biblical Jesus, you are not saved. For Paul warns us, there's another Jesus, there's another gospel, there is another spirit. You better have the one that's in the Bible that God has offered to you. I'm here to tell you, I'm going to stretch the binds even more. I'm going to put the bonds of hatred out there even more. You cannot have a white Jesus. You cannot have a Hollywood Jesus. A Hollywood Jesus will put you into the pit of hell as deep as it will go. You cannot have a black Jesus. A black Jesus will put you into the pit of hell just as much as a white Hollywood Jesus. You can't have a Republican Jesus. You can't have a Democrat Jesus. You can't have a Jesus that gives you free food every month. You can't have a Jesus that pays your bills while you sit on your fanny and do nothing. That's not the Jesus of the Bible. The Jesus of the Bible was a sinless perfection of God in the flesh, who is of the flesh and is God. If your religion proclaims that Jesus is not God, you are in a cult. And you will burn in hell for having the wrong Jesus. If your Jesus came to America to a bunch of Indians with Hebrew names, you've got the wrong Jesus. I have the sinless perfection Jesus Christ, who is God, and God is Jesus. The one that the Bible proclaims is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh unto the Father but by me. That is the only Jesus. The only way to get to the Father is by the true Jesus, that of the Bible, that of 48 prophecies, all fulfilled 100% by his first birth to his resurrection from the grave, the third day, which there are more prophecies, there are more testaments yet to fulfill, that the Bible says he's coming back, and if he can fulfill 48 prophecies, boy, is he coming back. And he will not be coming back as that little baby in a manger that you can hold, you can cuddle, you can dress, you can manipulate, but he's coming back as the Lion of God, the Father. He is angry, and he will get all you that reject him. You better rest assured, the Bible says that Jesus Christ is coming. He's coming. And he's coming back in anger. And you will not want to see him at that time. And yet that Jesus loves you enough that he is the only man who knew when he was born when he was going to die. Even I don't even know that. And not only did he know when he was going to die, he knew exactly how he was going to die. He knew about all the sufferings which he did for you. If I may read from Isaiah 53, if I keep my voice, Isaiah 53. For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, as a root out of dry ground. He has no form of comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men. Well, thank you very much, Daytona Beach, Florida 32114 zip code. You have made the Bible real. Thank you. Daytona Beach, Florida 32114 has proved the Bible to be right. He's rejected of men, and you are rejecting him today. The offer's on the table. You proved the Bible right. You can choose to ignore me. You can choose to ignore the Bible. But one day you will not be able to ignore him, as you are standing before him, being judged to cast off in the lake of fire for all eternity. He is despised despised and rejected of men yet today. He is despised and, rejected of men. A man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. You keep on going with your merry lives, and you have no respect to the author and finisher of our faith. You don't even want to hear it. You're looking at your watches. When's he going to be done? I wish he shut up. I wish he just go home. I wish he go away. He hasn't been here for 3 weeks. All right. Oh, he's back. You got your eyes on the wrong thing. You're to have your eyes upon the one that's rejected. You're to have your eyes upon Jesus. For only Jesus saves. No other. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Listen. Jesus Christ took the penalty of God's wrath that you may not have to. When Jesus was beaten, when Jesus was bruised, when Jesus was whipped, when he had his beard pulled from his face, when he was nailed to that cross, it should have been you. It should have been me. We should be dying and going to hell without any salvation. Yet Jesus took our pain. Jesus took our sorrow. He took our suffering that we may live. And yet you continue to reject what God has done for you. But he was wounded for our transgressions. If you choose not to believe, know for a fact that you did what happened to Jesus about 2,000 years ago. It was you that caused his pain and sorrow. It was you and your sins that put him on the cross. You are guilty of the death of the Lord Jesus Christ because all have sinned. You cannot do nothing to earn your salvation. It had to be done by God. You sent Jesus to the cross because of your sins. He died on that cross because you need a sacrificial, sinless Lamb atonement accepted by God and God only. Listen, Jesus is not even approved in churches today. He was bruised for our iniquities. Jesus took a whipping, if I can say reverently, because of you. All the pain and sorrow and suffering that he went through it because of you. You want to talk about a wife beater? What about beating Jesus because of what you are? No pain. They say no pain is no gain. Well, my Christ suffered pain that I may gain eternal life. It took a cross for my soul to be saved. It took the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, who is God, that I may be saved.